start with the Protostar Stack5 file. So to get started, we have to SSH as a user and into the IP address, and we are getting user as password, and now we are in. It's user, so I'm going to update this to a bash script shell. So I can do more things in this type of command prompt. So then I'm going to go to protostar bin file folder. So these are the files that we have. So what you're going to do is basically get this one done. So let's first see what are the strings here. Okay, nothing much, meaning there's no much input or output of this. So basically this is trying to do something. Let's see. Okay, so what we can do to this is like I'll get another terminal over here. So I need to like take something like a pattern to, I mean, to create a pattern to this overflow this one. So I'm going to maybe like use a pre available module for this. So let's like try it. Okay, let's go to this first, like a pattern create. Yes, this is the file that I'm going to use for this thing. So this is the base program, and this is I'm going to copy this and paste this here. So I'm doing this sometimes because this doesn't work the other way around. So I'm going to create a list of 100 characters. Let's see. Okay, I got the payload here. So I'm going to run this. Just copy this for the time being, and then run gdb on this stack5 file, and we are having this thing, and I'm going to set a breakpoint at main. Okay, so before that, let's just to get just to make sure that what are the functions here, let's take a quick dump of function headers. Stack5. So these are the functions available. We have main function, and then nothing much that will be of use to us. Okay. So we can see that there's a main function here. So I'm going to gdb, and let's just disassemble the main. Custom C. Okay, so these are the things here. We have move here, and it's called at this point, and gets function. I think this will be vulnerable. So let's go to it and set a breakpoint at main. Okay, so what we are trying to do is basically let's get another terminal, and get his here, and as usual, let's try Python and printing 100 A's or something into 64 again. Let's try 64 and see what happens, and then I'm going to pass this value to stack 5 file. Let's execute this and see, nothing happens. So 64 doesn't work. That means let's like increase it by 60 or something, and 76. Okay, we are getting a segmentation fault over here. So it's like pretty much like same as the previous one. So keep decrementing from like 4. Okay, I think it's happening at the 76 byte. So let's try 75. Yes, it happening as 76. So we just have to pass the payload into this one, and maybe like let's run this stack 5, and then let's again break at main and run the file. Okay, we are getting something. So let's see. Okay, continuing, and I'm going to paste this one, this payload over here. I'm literally passing this as a variable. So yes, we are getting a segmentation fault again. Program says it's excessive. So it crashes at like this memory address for 63. So what we are going to do now is we have to get the segment of this one, which segment actually it is happening. So I'm going to copy this one and then go here. So it's pretty much the same like this. So I just have to create this one is pattern offset. We have that here. So then Q, and just have to paste this one and remove the 0 and X, and C. Yes, we are getting exact match at offset 76. So just like that's what I just did here as well, 76. So what we are going to now, after getting this information, that you can just assume that we'll be able to get a root shell from this thing. So we have to prepare that as well now. So let's like do it like this now. So we are going to get here and get outside this thing, and let's find the exact match. So here, and then we have to find that whether it's binary or not. So let's simply use the find command to this, and then yes, opt protostar, and then bin. So what you're now doing is perm mutation perm. It has to be perm, and then 4000, and let's pass it and get a grep from that from stack 5.5. So it is a binary file, so we can get a root shell from this thing. So to pass the root shell, we have to like get some more information out of this. So let's go back to stack 5, and I'm going to set this disassembly flavor source and much more human understandable. So that's why Intel is being used. So we are going to disassemble main again. So these are the values we will be having here, and move push and all that, and we are having an interesting function leave. So it's pretty much the same as that earlier one. So d9, we have to keep this value, we have to set it as a little endian. Yes, so we can identify that the best place to set a breakpoint would be this. So this is happening right before the return function. So we see the address over here, so we are going to copy this one. So we are going to break at this function call. Yes, so we are setting a breakpoint at there, and then we are going to run this thing again. Okay, we are starting the program, and let's like set some A's. 8 A's and so like 16 A's, and we are getting an error like breakpoint has been triggered and all that. So after that we need to get the information of this frame, info frame. Let's see what we can get over there. So we can see that there are some language of C, and at least there's an argument list and add memory address and all that. So there are some saved registers as well. So there's something in the last line. So these are the EIP registers. Now we have to control this one to get the shell actually. So now we have to exploit this thing. So to exploit we have to get a shell code of this and before that. And also we have to like when we run this program in GDB, we are getting like something like changes in some changes in the stack. So we have to like approximately take these values, because the values will be changed by some few hundreds. So what we are going to do now is get some basic shell code for this one. So I'm going to like write an exploit for this. We have to write some simple Python script for this thing. So I'm going to like get nano shell Python is something I wrote earlier. So let's like run this stack5.python. Okay, so actually we shouldn't do this in our local system. We have to go and do it here. So let's go and write Python. Now we are going to write this, so we have to import structure for this struct, and then so the string will be passed as, so these are the values, so 41 actually that should be this, and then we have to like, since we got the buffer overflow at 76 value, we are passing 76 here. So when this buffer overflow hits the EIP, we need to get the new address of the EIP, and we are going to assign that one. So then it will always jump at 4 bytes, so it will be like over there, so we are going to get like COX. Yes, 8 digits and then plus 4 as well. So this will be the compensation actually. So we have to add 4 to this one. So meaning that we the value here will be changed. So after we add 4 to the register, it will be like 780. So we need to add that value to a variable. So but we have to write it in reverse as well, because we are getting this value in reverse, in sorry not reverse, in little Indian. So that is why we are getting the struct imported. So and we are getting it as we are going to pass this to a variable called EIP, and then it will go to struct. So we just imported this one and getting a pack of that, and then passing this in parentheses and just like close that one. So now we are going to put I inside this one. So and then passing these values, and then comes the difficult part, type in the shell code. Shell code would go like okay, I'm going to type something like x31 x0. So I'll just paste it over here, and we are getting this value, and that would be the shell code. And then we are going to pass some no pointer that way. So no operation pointers for this one. So then no operation would be like actually we have to pass it in parentheses as well. So like into 90, this would be the null byte or some sort of thumb, something like that. Then we are going to pass hundreds of that, maybe. Yeah, okay, maybe 100 of that one. So just to make sure it is enough, actually we had 76 here, so 100 would be the safest choice. So we are going to print this as, this is the output of the program. So we are getting string plus that EIP part plus this no part here, no function part, and then not operation and the shell code. So let's save this one now here. Okay, we can save that. So we are going to close this one and just copy this one for just to be safe. I don't have to copy paste this one yet. So yes, we are not getting the permission to do that. So what we will have to do is copy it, and I just want to do it like this. So let's go to the temporary file folder. Yeah, temp file folder would be good. We'll be having some access over here, I think. So yes, I was able to save. David there in the temporary folder. So let's get that running. Python, let's go to temp and stack5, and I'm going to pass this value to stack5. Okay, I'm getting something wrong. EOS can filter, so I have to edit the file again, maybe. Yes, so what do we have wrong here? Yes, so we don't need a dollar sign, actually, I just got it wrong, I think, there. So, what we basically need to do is set this over here. Maybe on this would be longer and then see. Yeah, it should do the trick now. I think I haven't pasted everything. So the shell code would be, there has to be more for this one. So let's try to paste it over here. Now see, okay, I think it's good enough. So let's try running that again. Okay, we are getting a segmentation fault over there. So that means again I'm doing something wrong, right? So the shell code over here, let's get back there. So I think I am getting wrong anywhere else. Is this pasting it over here, and then 41 76. So maybe like you can remove a part of this one here. I think there's a repetition over here. 31 up to 31, let's see. So what we basically need to do is to execute this function. So what we need to get now over here will be this actual. So let's see if it works now. So this is the whole function that we are getting. So let's see, save it and run it. Okay, you're getting another segmentation fault now. So I think I got the memory address wrong or something, and that's the problem. We have to go at like this, maybe. It's troubleshoot live. Okay, still the same problem running. So I think the no operation that you are using is too much for this thing. Maybe like let's decrease this like to maybe 16 or something. Let's try incrementing from that one and see. So let's try this. Okay, 16 is not working. Then let's go up a bit further. Let's go to 32. doesn't work like that. So let's get the little engine going out of this one. So basically the last two digits first. So we are going to hit X without getting this. Maybe like we have to make a little change here. I think because we are doing it with GDB and all that, we had some changes over there. So it should be off like in hundreds. So say make this 800. Let's try it like that as well. Take this at 800 and see. Run it and see. No, it's not working like that either. So let's try to do it like this. Pass the little engine parenthesis for this. Actually, let's change the whole code. So EIP would be we should go to 76 and EIP would be at 192. Find this out and see. Let's try it like this. X 00 as in 800, say 0, and then X 8. And then X 68. Let's put this tractor a bit, so it should be what was the first bit? It's an EF, right? So let's save it here and see. Yes, we are working, we are getting the shell. So who am I? I'm root now, so means the exploit success which happened and all. So I'm fucking happy now. So okay, so this is how to get this thing done. Stack 5 of the Protostar.